Hi everyone, welcome to my channel, Too Light to Be an Ebony. So by the title of this video, this is going to be kind of a chit chat, get ready with me to get to know me and what I want to do on this channel. Basically, I am not a makeup through YouTube, makeup through YouTube. So I'm just going to go through my makeup routine, tell you a little bit about myself. And it's going to be a glasses friendly type of look, my everyday normal just go to when I need to throw some makeup on. And yeah, if you see me, I'm just going to go ahead and get started and we'll see how this look turns out. So my name's Ebony, obviously, hence the name Too Light to Be an Ebony. Basically that just came from people always telling me, oh, you don't look like an ebony. Oh, you don't look like an ebony. My mom actually told me when I started like looking for jobs that I should go by my middle names, which are Lisa Nicole, and see if I get a job that way. I was like, bro, you named me this. Why would I not go by it just to get a job? But obviously, I was able to get a job. So, yeah, that's the story of my name, in case you were wondering. But, so I was born in Charleston, West Virginia. My dad, my little sisters, my stepmom, my grandmother, my aunt, they live there. My grandfather is buried there. He passed away 2 years ago on April 5th. I'm actually going to get a tattoo for him soon because I really miss him. Like, best grandparent ever. And I'm really close with my dad's parents, not so much my mom's because there's so many grandchildren. Like, my grandmother on that side had 8 kids, so there's a lot, and we're not very close. But my dad's side is just me and my twin sisters, who are 8 years old. Well, they're going to turn 8. Hopefully, I'll be able to make it to their birthday. I've never been able to make it to their birthdays because I'm always gone by the time they're... Well, I'm always in school, and I never get there in time for their birthday. But I buy them gifts and everything like that. So, yeah, from Charleston, West Virginia. I moved to Georgia when I was about 4 and have been here pretty much ever since. But I go back to West Virginia, obviously, because my family's there. And, I graduated high school here and everything. I went to college for 2 years in Greensboro, North Carolina at UNCG, which is University of North Carolina at Greensboro. I liked it there. I really did. I had an apartment there and everything. But tuition was expensive. My grades were getting pretty trash when I first got into my apartment, and then I finally brought them back up, but it wasn't enough to stay in the school. So I withdrew and I came back to Georgia. Came back to Georgia in August of 2015. I got a job at Kroger, got fired from there. What else? Then I started a CNA program here at Chattahoochee Tech and did that and got certified to be a CNA in January of 2017. Then, what else? Oh, yeah. And then I started working for a home health agency. It was okay. It wasn't bad. It was just kind of boring, honestly. I wasn't doing CNA things. I was basically a maid. So after that, I got a job at a nursing home, and that's where I currently work as a CNA on Saturdays and Sundays. And I'm looking for another job, preferably one involving makeup, because I really do like makeup. I got into it a little bit because I did a pageant. I did one pageant for like Miss Georgia Teen USA. Did not place, didn't make it past go, nothing. But it was still like a really cool experience. And then I did one pageant at my school that I actually won in my high school. And I was shocked I won that because I was up against like all the cheerleaders and all of that. And I was like, how did I win? Like, houseway. So yeah, that's my brief pageant history. But I really do love makeup. Like, it's transformative, and I really enjoy doing it.
I don't like doing it on the people. Like, the only person I will ever do makeup on is my little sister, but she's really good at makeup now too. But I did her makeup for prom. It's on my Instagram, too light to be Ebony as well, and you can see her. Fun fact, she actually wore my pageant dress that I went in to prom. It's a gorgeous dress, like gorgeous. But yeah, let's see what else. My birthday is December 11th. I am 24. I turned 25 this year. Scary as fuck. I'm scared as shit. I'm also starting at Kennesaw State University in June, which is also scary as fuck. Because I haven't been in school for a while, especially a traditional school. Like, yeah, I went to Chattahoochee, but it's not like a university by any means. They don't have dorms. I think they have sports teams, but not like a regular university. So, yeah, a little scared about that. And I'm starting off as biology, but I haven't decided if I want to go the RN route or do physician's assistant school. I'm still deciding. I think I'm going to apply for the RN. Like, try to get my BSN, get in the program, and if I don't, then I'll do PA. I think I've come to that consensus, either way, however you say it. Yeah, I think I've come to that conclusion. That's a better word. I think I've come to that conclusion that that's what I want to do. I'm also debating if I want to do, like, a minor in marketing or maybe psychology, but I haven't really decided that yet. So we're gonna go from there and see just how I feel about the programs and all that. But right now I am starting off just doing a general, like, a BS in biology. So I am single. I recently just went through a breakup and it's been hell. Like, hell on earth. Honestly, it's I hate breakups. And this one just really, like, it's gonna take a while for me to get over this one. It really is. Like, this one really hit me hard. And I don't know. And now it's like, I don't know how to kind of bounce back from it. So that's really one of the reasons I came back to YouTube. Because, like, I had started doing, like, vlogs and stuff. Just vlogs, because to be honest, I didn't have the equipment to do anything else but vlog. And yeah, I took all those videos down because of my relationship, because I wanted to start fresh on my YouTube with her. And yeah, just kind of didn't happen that way. But I needed something to take my mind off of the breakup, so I thought this was a good way to do it. I mean, and now I don't even know how to talk to anyone else. Like, a guy texted me, like, from a while ago. Like, I think I talked to him maybe a year and a half ago, 2 years, maybe, I don't know. But I do remember him. I just don't remember the time frame in which I talked to him. But yeah, he texted me and I don't even know how to, like, text. Like, I keep sending the monkey hiding its face because I'm just, like, awkward. I'm a fucking awkward ass turtle. I've accepted it though. And I let him know, like, look, this is what I'm going through. So if I'm just awkward, I'm shy, I don't know. And also, I'm still kind of holding out hope for her. Honestly, that's really, that's a major part of it. Like, I honestly would love to be back in a relationship with her, but I know I have stuff to work on. So I'd rather work on myself and not get be involved with anyone. That way, if me and her do attempt to try again, there's nothing in the way, if that makes sense. So yeah, that is basically where I'm at with relationship wise and all of that. I have five tattoos. I have my first tattoo was a rose I got after I turned 18. So I turned 18 in 2011. So 2012, that New Year's, I got a tattoo with my aunt who also does my hair. So yeah, went and got a tattoo with her, got my rose. I was saying I wanted a rose so much. Like, my dad was like, fine, get it. It's a tramp stamp, but I love it. Like, it's my first tattoo. Then I got my birthday in Roman numerals when I was in college. I don't know why I got my birth. I just wanted a tattoo, and I don't know. I got it. I remember my dad called me after I put it on Facebook and was like, really? Your birthday? And I was like, oh, you actually did the math to figure out what it was. Okay. So, yeah. Then my grandparents weren't too happy about that one. Then, they're low-key addicting. Because I love, it's just weird. I just like how they feel. So, yeah, after I got my birthday, I got a bow on my hip. But I got a tattoo on my hip-ish area, kind of sort of thing. And it's a bow, but like the center of the bow is a diamond. One of my favorites. It's really done really well, actually. Like, really well. I got another bow that was shitty. Literally, it was shit. I wanted a bow with, like, diamonds on the inside. Like, on the bow parts to mirror my other bow. And yeah, I didn't get that at all. I mean, I did. The lines were just, it was shitty, but I got it done for free. And yeah, we're gonna move on because I got it covered up. So that was like I got them both covered up at the same time. So I got two shitty tattoos from the same person. I know, I'm fucking dumb. So got two shitty tattoos, and the second one was a peach. It's supposed to be like a peach with a bite taken out of it. Don't ask me why I wanted that. Actually, one of my roommates suggested it when I got my apartment in Greensboro. I was like, oh yeah, that's cute because I'm a Georgia peach. It would have been cute had it been done correctly. But anyway, so I got them both covered up by another person, and now the bow is like zebra striped, kind of bow. And the peach is still a peach, just a full peach. No bites taken out, and neither one of them have color, which I hate. But they're there. I also have my nipples pierced. I got that done in college. I got a lot of shit done in college. But I couldn't help myself. Like, I really like body modification. That's why I like my hair. Is this reddish color right now, but I've had blue hair, I've had green hair, had purple hair, I've had blonde hair. I've had a lot of different colored hair. And I don't know, I just don't like looking the same all the time, if that makes sense. I really don't. Like, I like to change it up. And I've just started to get like that. Like, I started developing my style when I went to college, which I think a lot of people do. I feel like I was just late to the party. Honestly, like, in high school, I didn't have a style. I just wore what was on trend for then or whatever. But as of now, I've developed my style, and I'm glad I have, because it's really helped me like express myself in a way. But tattoos, piercings, hair dyeing, I do it all. I love them. Like, if I could, my whole body would be covered in tattoos, honestly. Like, it's ridiculous how much I like tattoos. Let's see, what else? I'm a huge Harry Potter nerd. Read all the books, seen all the movies, saw Fantastic Beasts. Like, if it has something to do with Harry James Potter, Hermione Jane Granger, Ronald Weasley, any of them, I've read the play, The Cursed Child. My dad pre-ordered the book for me because he knew how much I, like, loved it. Yeah, Harry Potter is my jam. Can't wait until the new Fantastic Beasts comes out. I forgot to blend out this concealer. Usually, I take a damp, a regular sponge to blend out that orange concealer, but it'll be fine. It's fine. But yeah, once I started learning, like watching YouTube, pretty much my whole makeup career is based off watching people on YouTube. Like, that's all I do is YouTube, and more YouTube. Trial and error, obviously. So, yeah. Three sisters. The twins are 8. Well, they're going to turn 8. And my other little sister, the one I did her makeup for prom, she just turned 16. She turned 16 in August of last year. Yeah. So, I have my hands full with siblings and also step siblings, but we don't. I only acknowledge a couple of them for various reasons. And some of them technically are not even step siblings because my dad and my stepmom are not married. They aren't, but they need to get married and stop playing around with my emotions because I love her. Like, she doesn't overstep any like parental bounds or anything. And I'm saying that like when I was younger, she didn't do it. And now I talk to her like a best friend. While on the other side of the coin, my mom did remarry and her husband, I call him her husband. I don't even call him my stepdad half the time because I just don't. It's just not my jam. Not how I feel. He overstepped it so much while I was in high school. Like, it's ridiculous. I hated it. I was like, sir, I don't even know you. Like, who are you? I hated him. Still not his biggest fan to this day, honestly, to be completely true. Just saying. That's personal reasons. Just things I've seen in general. And I'm just not a fan. I said, I'm not very close to my mother's side of the family. They live in Baltimore, Maryland. And my grandmother, again, had 8 kids. And each one damn near had, well, all of them have kids except for 2 of my aunts. One I'm really close to, my Aunt Michelle, I love her to death. She took care of me when my mom was in basic. Yeah, my mom basically just dropped me off in Baltimore with her family while she went into the military. But, like, so I'm not really close to my grandparents on that side because they have so many grandchildren, it's kind of hard for them to keep up with us, basically. Like, I think there's 19. Yeah, I think there's 19. But, me and my sister are cool. My mom and her dad. Me and her don't have the same father. I have no full siblings. Like, I am my dad and my mom's only child together. Which is cool. Kind of special. Kind of a black sheep type of thing. But yeah. So, me and her are cool now. Wasn't when we were younger. Like, we have an 8-year age difference. It's weird. Like, the twins, they're like babies when I was 17. So it's like, oh, they're like my little dolls. I can dress them up. But when I was 8, I was like, who are you? Why are you here? Pretty much towards my sister. She's at the age where I can give her advice about stuff now. Like, what are we gonna talk about when you're 8 and you're newborn? Like, it's not really, you know, a great way to build a relationship with the age difference that wide. But now we're cool. Give each other, give her advice. Try to be a good big sister type of thing. Process of trying to get her license, but she's following in my footsteps of not getting it at 16. Like, I got my permit and did not take the test at 16. I got my permit on my birthday, or like the day before, after my birthday, like really soon. Like, I was like the first one in my class to get my permit, and pretty much the last one to get their license, because I just got my license August 2016. So yeah, little late, so I drive her around pretty much during the week. I'm basically a prepaid Uber driver for her, but it's cool, which is weird because none of my exes ever got that close to my little sister ever. So we're basically like time sharing her now. Because it's like she was supposed to come see her off for prom, but there was a lot of people here that I wasn't aware was going to be here, so I didn't want it awkward for her either. So I understood like where she was coming from, but it was like, our child's going to prom, like, you gotta come see her. I understood like the awkwardness. No one wants to go through that. No one wants to do the elephant in the room. Like, her sister had a baby while we first started dating. She was born really close to my birthday. And her sister made me the godmom of her baby. But now, I don't know how that works, because we're not together. But I love her sister. I love all her siblings, actually. They were really cool. And I just love the fact that they didn't I'm sure it took them a while to accept her. Not really, actually. I don't think it did. Her parents took it kind of hard, but as far as like her siblings, that they really supported her, and her family like supports her being out and living life as a lesbian. Meanwhile, I came out with this relationship to my family, and no es bueno. Like, it wasn't the greatest, if we're being completely honest. Not at all. My mom said I was crazy and that she would pray for me and her. So it's been a really interesting transition, and I don't know, like, my relationship with my father has changed quite a bit. Like, we were pretty close, but now it doesn't seem like we are as close anymore, which hurts a little, but it's kind of like an adjustment period. Like, I didn't give him any signs, and then he kept saying, well, you weren't raised this way. And it's like, well, how do you raise a gay person? Or I have a cat, by the way. Thanks. And you expect him to be a certain way, like, I don't know. It's weird. I don't have many friends here. Like, I had good friends, like my roommates in North Carolina. They were cool, and I got really close to them and their friends. So yeah, basically when I came back here, like, my high school friends were with their new college friends. Like, I feel like the friends that make in college are the ones you take with you into adulthood. Not really the, not so much your high school friends. Like, some of them, yeah, if you're really close, I could get that. But for me, I don't know. It was a little, I didn't have much contact with them. Like, when I came back home for visits, I didn't see them. I just kind of stayed home and saw people who lived nearby just because they were nearby. Like, they were convenient to see. But as far as like female friends, I don't have any. Like, I have no female friends. I don't have any friends right now, actually. None. And I probably need some, which is another reason why I started YouTube. It's a way to get out my feelings and for frustrations and talk about it. And if somebody else is going through the same thing, they can connect. And, you know, just a support system kind of, sort of. And I really wish I had started this while I was in North Carolina, because I've been through some adventures there. I went to Miami through that. I got into my first fight through that. Like, I really should have started vlogging, but I didn't even know what vlogging was back then. To be honest, I didn't get into like YouTube vlogs and stuff until I came back here and just was exploring through YouTube, and videos kept popping up. Like Jamie and Nikki, their vlogs, I love them. I really hope they don't name their baby Sage. I really hope they don't. Like, I can't stand that name. No offense if your name is Sage, I just don't like the name Sage. And Nikki Tutorials, Jackie Ina, Time the Infamous was like one of the first people I actually watched. I love Time the Infamous. She is my favorite because she's just so over the top. And her makeup is like cake face, like full coverage or nothing. Like, And my ex actually got on me about my makeup sometimes. Like, she would be like, why do you wear so much? Like, why do you have to do so much? And it's like, because I don't like not doing it. Like, no makeup looks to me are like, why? I just don't get it. No offense to you if you do no makeup. It's just not my, it's not my stilo, not my steez. Just not for me at all, honestly. I don't know, being natural is vastly overrated. Kind of, sort of, type of vibe. I just don't like natural makeup. Like, that's your vibe, that's how you want to do it, you go ahead. It's just, that's not me. Not how I'm gonna do my makeup. I will do this until I have arthritis and can't. So yeah, that's pretty. Also, I'm very upset with the way this country is being run. My first time voting was in this election in which the Agent Orange Cheeto Puff was elected, and I was very upset. I don't even know why I voted. But, I mean, I know why I voted, but it's just, it sucks that this was the first time I voted. Like, and this is the result. Like, why? We couldn't do better, America. Now we're just going to be the laughing stock for the rest of our days. This is not what Hamilton wanted. Also, I listen to the soundtrack all the time. My sister gave me the book for Christmas that was written by Lynn about the process of how they created it, how it was written, how staged it, all that. And it has all the songs in there, all the lyrics. But it was before the mixtape came out and before the album actually came out. So I'm sure there are some words that are different, but everything is in there. And I finished it. It made me cry. At the end, it's just sad. Really sad. But I love Hamilton. Like, I did drama in high school, and I loved it. I wish I would have continued it. And I wanted to minor in theater acting, but that is not a thing at KSU, unfortunately. So I cannot do that. And I have YouTube now, which is a creative outlet that I'm really into. So hopefully that'll feed my need of, you know, expressing myself. One good lead, that was because the magnet program, oh yeah, I was in the magnet program in high school, but that ended up getting in the way of me being able to take like musical theater and things of that nature, because I had to take research and internship and just, oh god, there's so many things. But when I was able to take drama, I had a lead in a play called Night of the Living Dad. It was really funny. And it was like one of the best things I've done. Like, I think I had a semi-lead senior year, but Night of the Living Dead, that was, you know, my peak. Pretty much of my acting career. The program was cool. I think it prepared me for college. At least the intro classes, for the most part. They really pushed us. And I love my little magnet family. We lost a couple of people from our class. Rest in peace, Haley, and rest in peace, Curtis. Haley died a while back, and they both had sickle cell, which is the sad part. Curtis was hilarious. Like, his spirit was just really great. And he was taken way too soon. Way too soon. Haley as well. I was closer to Curtis than I was Haley. But, you know, both of them taken way too soon. So, it's really unfortunate. Really, very unfortunate. I want to say senior year was probably my best year. I would say that. I would go that far. Just because it's like you're feeling yourself finally, and you're trying. Everybody's like living their best lives in high school, pretty much. In high school, I had way more fun in college though. Way more fun. Spring breaks were always lit. Went to Panama City 2 years, then I went to Miami my last year. Miami is more for the older people who are going on spring break, like the juniors, the seniors in college. I can see that, definitely. Like, yeah, it's more sophisticated than Panama City, which, I mean, obviously, because Panama City is pretty damn ratchet. But hey, I met some really cool people down there as well. It's just all what you make it. But Panama City was fun. But, like I said, I work at the CNA right now at a nursing home. And it's getting a little difficult for me personally because it's a nursing home. No one's really there, you know, expecting to get better, if that makes sense. So, we lost a lot of residents, you know, from December to like this month. A lot of residents. I think we got up to 8, and now about, I think we got up to 8 or 9, and then we lost about 3 or 4 more. There's one I was, I am talking. Okay. She wants to speak to y'all for some reason. So, there's not a lot of us there. There was one when I first started, but she got moved to another unit. But yeah. Some of them I really do enjoy, like, have conversations with them, sit and talk with them, and they're really sweet, really kind. And then you got some that aren't. And I'm just gonna leave it at that. But yeah, some of their passings really did hit hard. There were some very unexpected, and then some we kind of saw coming. But each one is sad. Like, that's another life just gone, and it's like, wow. Like, I want to make sure whatever I do in this life, it was worth it in the end, because being around all of this just makes you like, dang. And it also makes you want to like take care of yourself as well. Like, just because I work there, like, I know what it's like. I don't want to be there. But then again, if I'm causing trouble, like some of these residents, I could see why my children would try to put me there. I could see it.
watching this in the future, y'all better not put me there. I don't care what I'm doing.
My mother is part of a sorority, and she has told me and my sister that if we pledge anything other than the sorority she is a part of, we will be written out of her will. And her grandchildren, if they pledge anything other than what her sorority is, they will receive all her red items in her household. That should give you a hint, and which is nothing, basically. It's some kitchen stuff. They will receive all her red items, no money, nothing of that nature, because they did not pledge the correct sorority. Me and my sister will be written out of the will. So take with that what you will. But she is in a sorority, and my dad is in a fraternity. My dad's a Kappa. I can say that anymore. Now he's focusing on my little sister's basketball careers. I tried to do it. Wasn't for me. I jammed my finger going up for a rebound, and after that, it was done. Done deal. I did cheerleading. But yeah. Let's see what else. Cat Mittens. I've had her since, how long have you been here, Mittens? 8th grade? Since about 8th grade, yeah. And she is my child, like my baby. She sleeps in my room with me and wakes me up and attacks me like a cat. But she is part of the family. Like, when I get my own place, I have to make sure it's cat friendly, because I'm taking Mittens. Like, she's coming with me, I think. I also want a puppy, but hey, we'll see what the future brings. But when I worked as a home health aide, I only went to one person's house before I left that job to the job I'm working now. But first off, he offered me vodka like the second day I came, and he really didn't know why I was there. Just he thought I was a maid, pretty much. Like, to clean houses and do all that. And if I was there working with him, like, further along, that he would marry me. And I was like, I don't think I want anything resembling that type of arrangement, sir. And it's not like he had money or anything, so really, what was I gonna get out of it? I don't know why. He was an interesting elderly gentleman. I cleaned for like an hour. Like, I knew what I was cleaning that day, and then like I would fold laundry and stuff, but that only took like an hour or so, and I was there for 3 hours. So the rest of the time I just kinda sat there, read books. I tried not to be on my phone because I was working, but he wasn't doing nothing, so I really hope this YouTube channel is a way for me to express myself and get my like creativity and frustrations out. Like, I really hope it does help, because honestly, I'm kind of not sure what else to do at this point. Like, school is school. I mean, we live in this country now, it's like you kind of have to have a degree or you're not gonna get anywhere. Like, they just make it so hard and push education so much, and it's like there are other avenues, but I feel like I'm kind of just stuck in this avenue of like, well, I started school, let me just go ahead and finish type. And my family is really like, education is number one. Like, you do it this way or you're not going to do anything at all. And I don't think that's true. So hopefully me doing YouTube and them seeing me like happy doing this will help them get me a little more. Because like I said I was the black sheep because I'm literally the only child between my mother and my father, like the only child they had together. So, I'm kind of out there. It's more so of just, I kind of stick out and I don't know. Like, I'm very quiet. Before you get to know me, like, I just sit and observe. And that's because, I don't know. I didn't have a voice in high school or growing up. It was just kind of, hey, this is how things are. Deal with it because you live here. So now I'm just trying to find what really makes me happy. I like having stuff to do for myself. Like, that's a little narcissistic, but I like myself. Finally, I'm starting to like myself. But I didn't like myself for a while. And I think that's important to know and like yourself. One thing I'm really grateful for my ex-girlfriend, because she really did show me that you need to do things that make you happy and not for this other person who could care less if you're happy because you're doing stuff for them. So as long as they're happy, they're not going to care about your happiness, and your happiness is the key here. Like, you're the one that needs to be happy with what you do and how you live. So fuck everybody else. And one of the things that really does make me happy is doing my makeup. So yeah, hopefully I'll be able to flourish a little more with this platform. And I hope you guys can support that and not be like negative. I really don't want negativity. That's not good for our growth. It's 2018. Like, come on now. We shouldn't be trying to tear people down because they're doing something that makes them happy. Like, who really cares? I really hope doing this will help me grow as a person and help anybody else who may be going through what I'm going through, stuck in this mindset of trying to break free from whatever boxed you in when you were younger or anything like that. So if that's you, continue to watch my channel and we can grow together. Like, my everyday type of go-to, like, just some browns in the crease, a shimmer on the lid, glowy skin, and a nice new lip combination. I hope you guys enjoyed watching it. I look beat as fuck, actually. Yas, bitch, yas. But so I just want to thank you guys for watching this video. And I look forward to you guys watching more of my videos. I can't wait to put out a lot of content for you guys. I'm really motivated to do it because sometimes you need that creative outlet. And I think this is for me. Like, I just would really appreciate any support anybody wants to give me. It'd be great. And if you have a channel and you're putting out content, I will support you as well. Like, I just want to be able to express myself, and I think this is the platform in which I can really do that. So thank you guys again for watching this. I hope I didn't bore you, and I hope you will come back for future videos. I hope you hit the subscribe button, whatever corner it's in, and like and share it with whoever you think might like it. Thank you guys so much from the bottom of my little itty bitty Grinch heart, and I will see you guys in my next one.